Hello everyone, my name is Don Coyne and welcome to another edition of Fish in the Ocean State. Today we're here at Snug Harbor Marina, which is in South Kingstown. This is your one-stop fishing source in Rhode Island, no doubt about it. You can come here for fishing supplies, for gas, or even to weigh in that whopper. And they also run some of Rhode Island's top fishing tournaments right out of Snug Harbor. On today's show, we hook up with a couple of guys that have had their share of tournament success fishing for striped bass. Gip Sisson and Brad Riggs tackle Bretton Reef. That's all straight ahead from Snug Harbor Marina, right here on Fish in the Ocean State.
You never know what you're gonna find out here.
Welcome back to Fish in the Ocean State here at Snug Harbor Marina in South Kingstown, your one-stop fishing source. Many of the top local tournaments in Rhode Island run out of here. They've got a doormat fluke tournament for the month of July where you could win possibly up to $5,000. And then there's June Madness Striper Tournament. Well, that one could possibly pay up to $10,000. No doubt, this is the place to come if you want to get your fishing season going the right way. And very centrally located, Watch Hill, just a little ways that way, Block Island straight out that way, and you could head that way maybe to go to Bretton Reef. And that's where co-workers Gip Sisson and Brad Riggs went as they searched for stripers. We set out of Fort Weatherall for the short ride to Bretton Reef.
Long commute.
Long commute. And the fish are here. This year, it's been very cooperative. It's been very good this year. Seems like when you don't have the influx of hoagies like we did have for the past 3 years, the fish will stay out front here longer, more food out here. The bait just didn't show up this year like they did last year. So the fish ended up staying out here.
Eels, the breakfast of champions.
Oh yeah, nothing but the fun.
Yep, there's some structure in here that the fish will lay on and hide, you know. Anything that can cause a little disturbance in the water with the tide where they can kind of catch that and ride it and just sit there right on the bottom and wait for bait to come by them.
Pretty small area we're talking about.
Yeah. One of many we'll probably go through today.
This spot in particular is a couple humps underwater, a little alley in between that they like to sit in. We're at the tail end of the tide here, so we'll see how much eating they have in them left.
Seem to do very well at night in here. You can catch a good night bite here. It can be epic at times. All the fish you want. And then other nights, you fish it hard for one or two fish. A lot of 40s out of here. Basically what we're trying to do here is cast out the eel in front of the boat, let the boat drift down on the eel. That way the eel's natural instinct is to swim down to the bottom. Bigger fish, especially in stripers, are always going to stratify, and the larger ones are going to be near the bottom, as close to the bottom as you can get. You basically want to make sure he's staying near the bottom. Give him a little head shake once in a while, keep him out of the rocks. All you're going to feel is a light tap-tap when they're there. Just going to give it to them for a second or two and then go ahead and set the hook.
The drift can be critical.
It's only 0.2.
0.2?
Yeah. We're not moving very fast here. I'd like to get at least a half a knot out of it just so we're our bait's moving across some fish and we're covering some ground at the same time. But again, tail end of the tide, the wind direction will determine that.
Soon, the first hookup.
There you go.
Didn't seem to have much shoulders on them, but we'll take them.
Gotta make the guy work. There you go.
Keys to this kind of fishing, too, is light tackle. It really helps be able to feel everything that's going on. Little guy.
Little guy.
Little runt.
More importantly, if they're finicky, the lighter tackle gets them to eat, typically. Bait's bigger than him.
We'll let him go. If we can find a bigger one.
Gip looking for the right depth.
For some reason, this spot, anything over 22 feet seems to be the magic number.
But variance is good. Variance. Sitting on the front or back side of
my favorite
of humps,
number in here.
Waiting for bait.
Either, roughly 28.
They work together, but that's not how Gip and Brad met. So how did they first
we haven't
hook up?
That day.
On a fishing charter. We had a client come to town and hired Gip to come out and take care of his fishing and kind of hit it off. So we've been working together for what, about 8 years, Gip?
Yeah.
See what fishing can do?
Gip grew up on these waters.
Father started taking me out here probably before I could walk.
My uncle and grandfather used to take me. I grew up in New Jersey, so started in the Hudson River, the clean waters of the Hudson. A lot of freshwater fishing, and went to college in Rhode Island and kind of fell in love with the saltwater fishing, but didn't do that much of it with college and starting to work until I met Gip, and we've been going crazy since.
Yeah, right.
I think it's in your blood. If there's water and you can find something to bite, and part of it's just being out here, peace of mind. There's a stripe
right up here if you want that.
It's right here. Yep. Swimming at us.
Gip grabs the net.
Just in case.
Just in case.
You never know what you're going to find out here. He hit pretty aggressive, too. He was hungry.
Yep.
He was hungry. Go find your bigger sister.
And that sister shows up when fishing the Ocean State returns.
Nice fish.